recently, lah. Wait, let me see the history first. History. The history first, okay. Sit down first. Is it today's date, lah?
Today is the 15th of December, 11 o'clock.
15 December 2014, okay. This multi-pool, male, not neutered, 14 years old, came in on 9th of December, which is about 6 days ago. For what purpose on the time you came in? The swelling, swelling,
yeah,
swelling of this breathe. Swelling of this right side submandibular area, we call it. And also difficulty in breathing.
Yeah.
And this swelling was very painful and very large. Almost like what I call that? It's like a small golf ball. Actually. But the swelling seemed to have disappeared after treatment and antibiotic. And his breathing actually is, I guess, it's back to normal. Now, so we are just reviewing the case, and the X-ray did show the swelling very prominently, but now I can feel it. It's gone down quite a lot, actually.
Okay.
In fact, almost can't feel it.
Yeah,
but it's still painful. So there's still pain there. So there's still some infection there. Otherwise, it won't be painful. But it's not like last time like that. So the diagnosis will be based on blood tests. And examination will be an infection. Now this infection comes from probably inside the mouth, because it's got this bad teeth there.
Okay.
Periodontal disease.
Okay.
And the bacteria probably went through.
Okay.
Under the neck. Now you see this.
Okay.
It went through, and then the lymph nodes, the submandibular lymph nodes, cannot fight the bacteria,
yeah.
And so it increases in size.
Mm.
Now we look at the blood test. Now, let's see the blood test result. Now, this is a very interesting case, because normally, if we get 68.5, which is about 5 times, or 4 times higher than the maximum, and this is very rare, that means there's a lot of bacteria, so that the body has to produce white blood cells to fight the bacteria.
Okay.
And then we look at this 98% of neutrophils. Neutrophils should be 60 to 70%,
okay.
But 98% means the bacteria reproduce quite a lot of this. This is to fight the white cells. This white cells is called neutrophil, to fight the bacteria. And it can't fight, because otherwise the dog won't be here. I mean,
yeah.
6 days ago. And then you see the absolute. Now this absolute numbers of neutrophils, 67.13. Now the normal dog, the absolute number is only 3 to 11.
Okay.
So you can see that his body's immune system is really producing a lot of neutrophils to fight the bacteria.
Okay.
Now, the important thing in this one, actually, the platelets.
Mm-hmm.
Platelets is for clotting. So if the platelet is low, it's a sign of toxic blood. Now you see the normal is 200 to 500.
Yeah.
So 142 is below normal.
Yeah.
So it indicates a poisoning, toxemia or septicemia. In this case, based on this neutrophilia and leukocytosis, we know that this is due to the bacterial poisons, toxins, killing the platelets. Overall, the dog was treated with antibiotics and painkillers, and it seems that today he's much better. In fact, that day he nearly died of heart attack, because at one stage his tongue went purple because he was barking at another dog. See?
Okay.
Come here. He was barking at another dog. For some reason, the other dog was barking, so he wanted to bark also. But when he barked, the tongue all turned purple, and he collapsed. So it was very boring for me. So I need to, that time I quickly massage his heart. So you could punch his heart. Otherwise, he wouldn't stimulate the heart. And luckily, he recovered and pulled his tongue so they can breathe. Otherwise, if you don't do that, he probably die because of not enough oxygen. The tongue was all purple, and it was really. He was really trying to outbark the dog. There was another dog, Spitz. The Spitz was barking. He tried to outbark the fellow, but his heart can't take it, or his lungs can't take it. So now it's okay already. So we will just continue with the antibiotics.
Okay.
His appetite is good.
Yes.
It's too normal.
Yeah.
Let me just check the heart.
Does he need to extract his tooth?
Yeah, yeah. He needs it. But
let
me check. Let me check his heart again. Huh? We'll close his mouth first. He certainly looks okay for anesthetic. No breathing problem, right?
Gradually is when it became better. So it became better gradually after he saw it. So after it taking the antibiotics, just recover.
So the best is we will give take a blood test to check whether the bacteria is still around, and then give antibiotics for another 7 days. After 7 days, it should no more pain.
Okay.
So when there's no pain, then we will just do his teeth. Because now I'm worried that he's not fully 100% recovered. So just have a quick see, his color is very good now. It's pink. See, you see actually the back one.
Okay.
Okay. Then you want to bite me already? Okay.